And Stu, the shockwaves of the Vermont Yankee decision are obviously sweeping across the region. Still, according to a longtime opponent of the plant, the actual future of the site won't be clear for at least another 6 years. News Channel 5's Lauren Victory joins us live in the newsroom with that part of the story. Lauren.
That's right, George. Well, the Entergy website, too, says plain and simple, the entire decommissioning process for Yankee will take years, likely decades.
The news that Vermont Yankee will be closing came as a shock to Arne Gunderson.
It was, oh my God.
But the nuclear engineer, who's been lobbying against the plant for 10 years, says the place won't immediately turn into a ghost town.
It doesn't mean that we're out of the woods from a safety standpoint.
Even after Yankee is shuttered in about 15 months, Gunderson says there still will be plenty of activity, at least for a few more years.
The first step is wait 5 years and get the nuclear fuel out of the fuel pool, which is way up high, down into dry cast storage on the ground.
Entergy officials have stated they expect to finish decommissioning the plant through a process called safe store. They said the facility would be drained, secured, then let be for decades. Gunderson isn't a fan of that plan.
What happens in those 60 years is that the plant physical structure deteriorates and lets in things like rodents.
He thinks the better and quicker option is to knock all of Yankee down, but that's expensive.
It's going to be $1 billion to decommission this plant.
And about half that bill could fall to Vermonters because of federal regulations. Again, that crossroad decision is more than 5 years away. In the interim,
it's really critical that the Nuclear Regulatory Commission and the state watch to make sure that safety isn't diminished. The last thing we need is an accident, you know, in the last year of this plant's operation.
He writes on its website that safety is a top priority and that it plans to keep current staffing levels until the plant shuts down next year. Live in the newsroom, Lauren Victory, News Channel 5.